Hello, and welcome back to our series on Battletech Advanced 3062, the updated mod that includes the ability to engage in combat with the clans. And that's what we're going to do today. We've got a great battle set up here with Clan Wolf. It's a 4.5 skull mission. Let's jump right into it. This is where the pictures show a hostile lance touching down. Move up, make contact. Let's see what we're dealing with. Expect serious resistance. Okay. All right, so where are the enemy units? All right, enemy units are on top of the hill there. Unfortunately, some of my units are on the bottom of that cliff there, so we're going to keep our units together. So for this mission, we've got an Annihilator. We have a Royal King Crab, which is stuck on the bottom of the hill. So we're going to move everyone together so we can get off this cliff together. We've got a Stone Rhino, which I put together after salvage a couple missions ago. We've got a Warhawk. We've got a second Warhawk. And we've got two Shadow Cats for flanking and sensor duty. Ooh, all right, so we got hostile reinforcements that are actually moving up here. We're actually in a pretty good position that we might be able to ambush these guys. So we're gonna have to hold off on attacking the enemy because it's gonna be far better to take out these reinforcements first. Joining me also is Alex of Commando Gaming. He's gonna provide some occasional commentary.
And constructive criticism.
So Alex, we've got a enemy up on top of this hill over here, and then we've got some reinforcements coming in. I think I should take out the reinforcements first.
Just take out what I was closest.
Alright, that would be the reinforcements, so let's do that. Let's move.
Unless the main force would end up behind you, then you would want to
move. Our Shadow Cats, so we got a Royal Stalker, an Imp, a Warhawk, and a Hellbringer. It's a pretty sizable reinforcement force. Let's see, probably the most dangerous here is the Warhawk. We've got good hit percentages on this 100-ton assault. So let's take our first shot there. Since these are our scouts, we're also putting a tag on them with this volley. So that'll help our other pilots. Let's get our other Shadow Cat over here, full speed. And we can take a shot at this Hellbringer, also put a tag on it. Push everybody else forward towards these reinforcements. Right. Best shot here is with this on this Stalker, so we'll take this shot. Right. Good hits there on the AC. Right. Let's push forward our other Warhawk. Best shots on the Imp, so we'll take that shot. One hit out of two. Alright, so these reinforcements got surprised by us and ambushing them. So let's see what they do. Taking some shots at our scouts, not unexpected. As long as they stay evasive, though, it should be fine. Ooh, got some good hits on our Shadow Cat there. And we have a pilot injury. That was a lucky shot. Lucky for them, not for us. Alright. All right, let's start bringing the big guns in. Start out with our Stone Rhino. Our Stone Rhino has two Gosses and two PPCs. Not the best hit percentages, but we'll take the shots here. Alright, we hit up with one of the Gauss rifles, not too bad. Alright, now we have our Annihilator. Annihilator has four Ultra AC-10s. Good hit percentages here. Go ahead and take this shot. Ooh, good hits there on that imp. That's a really nice start. Alright, then we got our King Crab, who's still stuck on the other side of this cliff. So at least it can use its ATM-12s here on the imp. Maybe get a knockdown. Yes, we got knockdown. That's good. Thing that Stalker did by turning is it actually gave us a great shot to shoot him from behind with our Shadow Hawk. So let's do that. Nice shots into the flank. Oh, and we can actually do that again. This Hellbringer is also giving us a shot at its rear. We'll take that shot. Hellbringers don't have a lot of armor in the rear. And there goes the Hellbringer. Nice backstab. Shadow Cats are really good at doing these backstab maneuvers where they can take out a mech that's much heavier than them simply just by getting into that rear arc. Okay, our Warhawk A. Should probably try to do some more damage to this imp. Off our missiles, and we'll just focus on using lasers. Try to shear off one of the legs here. Not quite. Alright, we got some shots coming from the top of the hill, which is the original force that we were supposed to take out. But if they don't push down the hill fast enough, we should be able to finish off this reinforcement force before they can become a part of this fight. Let's go after the legs here again on this imp. All right, there we go. We took out one of the legs. The stalker's coming in for melee, and it missed. That was fortunate. That was pretty much a waste of the stalker's turn. Alright, the Warhawk's pushing forward. It's probably the biggest threat right now. Fire coming in from the top of the hill. Alright, let's move forward our Annihilator. Right, our Annihilator has really good hit percentages here on this Warhawk. So let's do a center torso shot with all those Ultra AC-10s. Right in the center torso. Oof, lots of damage there on that Warhawk already. Alright, the imp is up. Doesn't have a lot of firepower left. Our Stone Rhino. Primarily set up as a direct fire support mech. Let's put all of its shots into the other leg of the imp here. Ooh, he ejected. Two salvageable parts. I've never seen an imp before, so I don't know when we'll see one again. Alright, so that's two of the reinforcements down. So battle's going really well so far. Let's see if we can get knocked down on that Warhawk. There we go, knocked down. Mirror to backstab this Royal Stalker.
I know I've said this before, but it's not backstabbing.
Okay, shoot him in the back. Is that more appropriate?
Yes.
Right, so we're going to shoot him in the back. Not once, but twice. Both of our Shadow Cats. This should be enough firepower to hopefully finish him off. He's taking a beating in the rear armor. Not quite enough, but we did a lot of damage. That stalker's in a bad way. Multi-target here. Hoping we can get a dual knockdown here. Let's see what happens. Warhawk is already down. Serious damage there. Almost knocked down that stalker. More long-range firepower coming from the top of the hill. Really want to take out my Shadow Cat. That Warhawk. One salvageable part. That Stalker's trying to get some revenge from all that backstabbing.
Shooting in the back.
Shooting in the back. As Alex of Commando Gaming prefers that I would say instead of backstabbing.
Because it's more accurate.
It probably is more accurate.
Backstabbing is when you turn on someone. It's not literally being hit in the back.
Alright. Let's push our Annihilator up. This Annihilator can make short work of just about anybody. So I'm just going to do precision strike right in the center torso on the Stalker. Don't care about salvage on a Stalker. Oh, didn't finish him off. I thought that would for sure. Stone Rhino 4. Direct fire support. Dual gauzes. Yeah, we got knocked down on the Royal Stalker. Probably should eject right about now. He doesn't have a good situation.
Your guy?
No, the guy that I just knocked down. He's outnumbered, he's outgunned, he's just been knocked down. I probably would have ejected. But, you know, clanners are crazy.
Yep.
Alright, in the meantime, let's start moving our scouts up to try to figure out what's on top of that hill. Finish off the Stalker. There's almost nothing left in the center torso. There we go. There goes the Stalker. Two salvage parts, not really worth salvaging. We only get three parts out of this mission, and I don't think I'm going to be taking Stalker parts. Alright, now we've got a bit of a challenge, because we've got a sizable enemy force on the high ground. I don't know if we want to go up. Oh, they're at least sending one mech towards us to try to get vision on us. So that actually works to our benefit. Alright. Let's see what we're up against here. Alright, so we got a summoner and a 100-ton mech that's just outside of sensor range. We have a summoner here. Summoner, we really don't care about.
What
salvage.
Can a summoner do? Can it summon other mechs?
No.
Does it have a radio to call for backup?
Well, a summoner is what the Inner Sphere calls a Thor. And it's not bad for a 70-ton mech, but it just doesn't have the firepower to stand up to what we have on the field right now. They're basically using the summoner as a target and to give them vision on us so they can shoot everything else at us. So the easy solution for that is whenever the enemy sends out somebody to be their scout,
kill them.
We take them out as quickly as possible.
I thought that was the default option. You see an enemy, you kill him.
Horrible hit percentages here on the summoner, but we've got plenty of ammo, so let's take these shots. Nice damage there. Okay, here comes 100-ton mech. King Crab is now in range with all of its weapons on this summoner. This King Crab has been modified with clan technology, including an Ultra AC-20, a Gloss Rifle. A Gloss Rifle. It's related to the Gloss Rifle, but slightly different. And a whole
What's
bunch
different
of
about it?
Medium lasers. Probably the name.
Yeah, you would think. You would say that the name would be a
so
little
let's
different.
Go ahead and take the shots on the summoner here.
Okay, that's a glyph. That's a glyph.
Don't really care about salvage on the Thor. So I'm just trying to. The best situation is every time you take out an enemy mech, then they have to try to send another mech to get vision on you so they can shoot off screen. So the best things to do is just keep pounding these scouts as they come out. Bad hit percentages there, but it's all right. All right. So let's get our scouts pushed up here and try to figure out what we're up against. What do we have? We got a Dire Star with an Elite Gladiator. That's a very powerful mech. Oh my. Okay.
What?
So, Alex, the Dire Star Clan Wolf Assault Mech is armed with 9, 10 ERPPCs.
Wow.
So I think that just became one of our primary targets.
Yeah.
Wow. That is OP.
You're dead.
Well, luckily it doesn't have a lot of armor, because with all that firepower, it has like almost no armor. So we're going to have to try to take advantage of that. Alright, so we got a summoner. We have an Atlas, which would be good salvage. Alright. See if we can at least get knocked down on that first summoner. Since it has vision on the rest of our force. Or we could just blow it up altogether. That works too.
Yeah, that works. What was the name of that other super OP mech?
Dire Star. Pretty crazy. Now, it has all those PPCs, but it has, like, almost no armor. So, this is going to be an interesting fight. I've never fought against one of those before. All right, so we got an Atlas here. It's just a regular Inner Sphere Atlas. I don't think we're going to want salvage on it because there's going to be other things. So let's just hit the center torso hard. See if we can crack it. Hit the Dire Star here, which is good. If we hit it, good, we got a good hit there, because we want to disable the sensors of the Dire Star, because it has all those. I can't believe it has 10 ERPPCs. but it has like no armor. That's a pretty crazy combination. Let's move up our Annihilator. Maybe the Annihilator will be the target of the Dire Star. Okay, Dire Star is moving. I've never heard of this mech before.
What mech?
The Dire Star.
You haven't?
With all those...
How? You have over like 3,000 hours in this game and you've never heard of a Dire Star?
I know. I've had 3,000 hours in this game and I've never
what?
Come
That's
up against a Dire
hat.
Star. Taking out this Dire Star is definitely the priority here. Two good hits there. Shooting that Dire Star in the back. It might have some powerful weapons on it, but it's got locust armor.
The Dire Wolf?
No, the Dire Star.
Or the Dire Star, that's what it was.
The armor was horrible. There we go, there goes the Dire Star. And we got 3 salvageable parts. That might be one that we want to put together. I mean, if you used it correctly, if you had a mech that had 10 ERPPCs, it could be like maybe the ultimate sniper platform.
Yeah.
But its armor's like paper, so you'd have to definitely keep it in the rear and just have it engage at super long range. Alright, so we've still got an Atlas to deal with. And there's still 2 other mechs up there on top of the hill. I don't know what they are yet. We got a Marauder 2C. Not too dangerous. Got a lot of armor, but it's so slow. Right. It's always funny to me when the enemy uses an Atlas to attack something that really isn't worth its time. Like in this case, the Atlas is attacking a Shadow Cat while my Annihilator is just right there for the taking. Alright, so let's see what this Annihilator can do with focused fire right on the chest of that Atlas. Hit. All right, let's push up our Stone Rhino. Again, let's go ahead and do center torso strikes on that Atlas. And we got knocked down and structural damage. Let's move up our King Crab. And let's see if we can finish off that Atlas. Our torso shots. There we go. There goes the Atlas. With 3 salvageable parts. We're going to have some tough salvage decisions here.
Yeah.
I think I have to take that Dire Star just because it's a real interesting mech. Alright, so we got got another mech over here. We got a mech on the top of the mountain here. Let's try to figure out what that is with the sensor lock. It's an 85 tonner. Royal Stalker. Okay. So we should be able to take out what's left here pretty easily. This Marauder 2 has inner sphere technology. It's really not that much of a threat. I think my Shadow Cats could eventually take it out by themselves. Right, we got a Stalker. Ouch, ouch, ouch. That's a lot of firepower on my poor Shadow Cats.
What was that from?
From the Stalker. Good hit percentages here on the Marauder 2C. I don't think we're going to want salvage out of this, so I'm just going to go ahead and hit the center torso. A couple rounds of center torso shots should finish that guy off pretty quickly. Hits on our Shadow Cat. All right, let's finish these guys off. It's starting to become a problem, but we got plenty of firepower. All right, there goes the Marauder. Two. One salvageable part. I'm not really that interested in that, though. All right. Let's see. All right, we can actually get our Shadow Cat in. The Stalker in the rear. Let's keep the other lots of firepower in on our Shadow Cat there. Right. Just need to take the Stalker out. I don't care about salvage on this Stalker. Do as much damage as quickly as possible on this guy. wants to stay at long range, he can do that. It's probably not going to help him very much. Well, he's staying out of the range of the Annihilator for at least a round. So we've got the Royal King Crab. Shots went wide. We've got the Stone Rhino. Gonna risk overheating here one round. Shadow Cat. Okay. Shoot him in the back, maybe finish him off. Not quite enough. So we're gonna do the same thing with our other Shadow Cat. It's a little bit of a problem here. Cause him to eject, and that should wrap that one up. All right. I was worried about that mission being a little tough. But it worked out all right. Okay. Ooh, so the Shadow Cat almost got... This is what caused the injury to Ymir. He got a headshot. He'll be out for 14 days. Other than that, we got a little structural damage to our two Shadow Cats. No damage to our other mechs. Not so bad. So now we gotta figure out what to do with this Savage here. So we got this Dire Star. Called the Dire Star because it glows as bright as the sun when it fires. This monster mech carries 11 clan mech ERPPCs. Of course, it can't fire them all at once. It can barely fire two, but that's not the point. The point is to vaporize the target and inhale a PPC fire and then shut down and vent massive waste heat. The mech carries virtually no armor as the default, being exclusively a first strike weapon. So, It's got no durability. So that's really interesting, but I don't... I don't think that the Dire Star, as cool as it sounds, is the right choice here. Let's look at our other options. The Imp 1B. I only have two parts of that, so that's not going to really help me. So I think we're going to do is we're going to take the Atlas. It is a clan Atlas. Everything else salvage wise was negligible, but we did get an Atlas, so not so bad. It's a clan Atlas, you know. It's still not a clan top to bottom mech, but it's still an assault. that going for us. Alright, we're going to need some repairs. And our mech warriors are gaining experience. So let's take care of our mech warriors first, real quick. Alright, Corsair. Level 10 gunnery. Gridlock, level 9 gunnery. Rhino. Maximize your piloting, buddy. Scramble. Increase your piloting. And your mirror, even though you're recovering, will max out your piloting. You'll be back in 14 days. That's fine. We have a backup sensor locker. So. Look at our next problem. I've got to repair the Shadowhawk. It's going to take one day. I love these clan mechs because they can get repaired so quickly. It's going to take us one day. Shadow Cats will be up in 2 days. Alright, so we now have an Atlas available. So let's put our Sun Spider into storage. We also have a Stone Rhino, but we already have one Stone Rhino. We don't need those. Alright, let's put this Atlas out on the field. Alright, Atlas Seas is a clan retrofit. The AC autocannon and missile launchers with clan standard Ultra AC 20 and Swarm LRM compatible LRM 20 and Shriek SRM 6 launchers. With the inner sphere, medium lasers remained unchanged. Lighter clan components allowed the Atlas C to carry 3 tons of autocannon ammunition. Alright. Alright, let's take a look at our new Atlas. Right. As you can see, the Ultra Cannon 20 is dominating its firepower. Still has that Streak LRM 20, which is nice. Stream SRM 6. And it's got a whole bunch of medium lasers. So probably next time we travel, there's a couple things I want to do here. So it doesn't have double heat sinks. It just has regular heat sinks. Question is, you know what, we're going to go ahead and rebuild this right now, because there's a lot of things we could do. So we're going to take out the heat sinks. We're probably going to take out those medium lasers too. Take out these other heat sinks. I really didn't do this thing justice. Like, they gave it some good clan weapons and said, yeah, that's really all the money we want to spend on this thing. But we can do a lot of things here. Alright, so first and foremost, we're going to take an XL engine, put it in there. Not enough free slots. Oh, okay. So what we need to do, we need to move some of this ammo. Alright, we you now have enough free slots. There we go. So that gives us 27.5 of tons to play around with. So one thing we can do is let's look at available engines. Do we have one that will speed this puppy up? So we got 84 miles. It's not too slow for an Atlas, but can we do 88? Try the 380 core. Alright, now that means we should be able to do 2 + 4. Yes, we can do E+4. Gives us 13 tons remaining. Plenty of firepower here. So what we need to do is we're going to put it in a heatsink kit clan. See how that immediately improves the heat sinking availability. Put the heat sinks into the arms. Right, do four double heat sinks. All right. Now let's look at our weapons. I see this being really a mech that we want to allow to focus on using the AC-20, the LRM-20. Commando Gaming, tell me what else you think I should do with this Atlas. I've got 7 tons left besides selling it.
Make it even better so you can sell it for more later.
That's one thing we can do.
Sorry, as you guys have seen over on my channel, we've been playing quite a bit of GTA, so money is on the mind.
Alright, let's see, we can put an AMS. See if we can put an AMS on this bad boy, if we have AMS available.
How expensive is
we
it?
We do. We have, there we go. So we got some AMS.
How expensive is it, though?
AMS?
Yeah.
Well, we already had it in storage.
Oh.
So it didn't cost... All right, let's max the armor on this bad boy. That gives us one more ton to play with. Should we do? I don't think there's anything else we can do except we can put on a
Snickers.
What if we did a dual AMS?
Nah, it's a waste of tonnage. It's not really gonna improve your chances.
Yeah, because we got dual AMS.
Still, the chances will not double.
Yeah,
you would just have the same chance of hitting. You just have more bullets flying.
That works for me. I think
Why not just put on more AMS ammo?
Because we don't have any AMS ammo right now.
So it's not very efficient to have two AMS systems being supplied by one AMS ammo.
Well,
it's not a lot of ammo to.
We'll eventually
around.
Get some AMS ammo, I'm sure. Alright, so we gotta take 2 days to repair.
And the Atlas. And the Ymir? Oh, that's not a mech, that's a guy.
Ymir is out of action for 13 days. So should we do one more mission for this video?
Yeah, might as well.
Alright.
Yeah. For some reason, when I saw Ymir, I thought of like the giant Marvel ice creature. You know him?
I don't know that guy.
It's basically a really huge frost giant.
All right. So
as far as I know.
So we got one more mission left on this planet. It's a destroy base mission in the Badlands. So temperature is going to be key. Comstar is going to hire us to go after Clan Wolf with 7 pieces of salvage.
Probably going to get a ton of locusts
stuff. I'm a little nervous. This sounds a little too easy. So we got a destroy base mission. So we're going to take our Annihilator, King Crab, Stone Rhino, Warhawk.
So same first loadout.
We'll take our other Warhawk.
Wait, I thought those slots were for lights only.
No, we now have upgraded the Argo to the point that our max is simply 600 tons. So I can take any max as long as it's less than 600 tons.
So you can take, well, you could take 6 assaults, 600 tonners.
We could. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to take Rhino.
You should put Rhino.
Gridlock is our backup sensor locker, so we'll put that in the Shadow Cat. So we'll have 2 Shadow Cats.
You know, it would be kind of ironic if you had Rhino pilot Stone Rhino.
That's true. Except we need him to do sensor locks. Alright, and then we'll use Wildfire in the other Warhawk. And we'll let this thing load up. So this is a destroy base mission. So, hopefully taking a lot of firepower will pay off. We got an Annihilator, a Royal King Crab, a Stone Rhino, a Warhawk, 2 Shadow Cats. That should help us handle just about anything.
Yeah.
So, I didn't take the salvage on that Dire Star while you were out of the room, Alex.
Why?
Because... well, it had 10 ERPPCs.
You wouldn't get any of them.
No, you could get them if you put it all together, but it had the equivalent armor of a light mech. So I was like, I don't know when I'm going to ever use 12 ERPPCs or 10 ERPPCs on a mech that can get knocked over by a locust.
It would be good if you kept it in the back.
But we did get a full clan atlas, so I did take that instead.
Okay. That works.
So we'll load this up. While this is loading up, Alex, why don't you tell us what else is going on the Commando Gaming channel?
We did recently start making videos on the game Bomber Crew. It's actually up on my desktop right now. That's what reminded me about that. We only have one video out right now. We are going to try and make another one either the day of this recording or the day after.
Another Bomber?
Crew video, yes.
Crew video? Those are very entertaining videos for people who like to do kind of laid-back
strategy
games. That's probably a pretty good description.
Well, I wouldn't recommend it laid back. It does get pretty chaotic.
Yeah.
When you have to line up for a bombing target and you have like 15 fighters shooting at you, and you constantly have to send guys to go reload and heal,
mm-hmm.
It does get pretty chaotic.
But that game can be played by all ages, right?
Yep. Unlike the other game that we like to play a bit more on our channel, Grand Theft Auto, which is more for the older people.
Mm-hmm.
But we have been having some issues getting enough people to do some the videos on GTA Online, so we haven't done very many videos on that lately.
All right, so we've dropped down, and we're being told this is a secure facility. Halt and identify yourself. We're turret inspectors. We're here to clean your turrets.
That's a very, very good excuse. So believable. I would believe that.
Who is this? What is your operating number? Enough, Simri. Commander, your targets are just ahead. All right, so this is going to be... All right, so we've got...
It'd be funny if they were, like, told us exactly what turrets they have. Like, oh, you are? Okay. So we got turrets here, 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 and here, and then got, like, a heavy anti-tank turret over there, anti-personnel turret over there.
Yeah, so we got to destroy the detention facility, destroy the base garrison, and destroy Support Lance 1.
So basically you're destroying a prison.
Yep, we're destroying a prison.
Why?
Probably to let the prisoners escape.
If you're destroying the place, wouldn't that kill all the people inside?
Maybe our employers don't want the people inside testifying against them. I don't know.
And it doesn't really matter.
We're just here to destroy. So we've got a pretty heavy ton Lance plus some reinforcements to handle this. So I'm feeling pretty good. So I think we're going to slowly move over there, which tends to be the case when you have a bunch of assaults.
Yeah.
Let's push up our Shadowhawks maybe to the right. See if we can start getting vision on these guys.
I wonder what would win. 8 stone rhinos or 16 locusts?
I think I would put my money on the stone rhinos.
Yeah, sure, it's double the locusts.
Yeah, I mean, I think I could use a paperclip to take out a locust.
Yeah.
But, you know, that's deceiving because
no,
in real life...
No, you can't use a paperclip to push a...
In real life, a locust could probably take out hundreds of infantry pretty easily just because...
Of the size and...
Yeah, it could just step on people.
It could, but against real Max.
It's a locust.
Yeah.
Alright, let's keep pushing forward with our assaults here. And either our assaults are gonna get to the prison and destroy it, or they're gonna have to fight us. So there's no reason for us to be overly sophisticated because we've got a lot of firepower here. So let's move our keep moving our Shadow Cats to try to find the enemy. All right, we got enemy contact.
Yeah, as I was saying, you can't really use a paperclip to puncture a paperclip, because that's probably what they use to put, or either make the armor or attach the armor.
Alright, so we got a 75-tonner. I'm going to say it's either a Marauder or a Night Gear or something like that. Let's see. Let's push forward with our Shadow Cat. And, oh, we got multiple targets. A 30-tonner.
What?
This is going to be a quick mission if they're sending 30-tonners. Oh, we got a Timberwolf, which is good. I would like to get salvage on a Timberwolf.
Yeah, they're not bad.
Well, it's my favorite heavy mech.
I thought they were all your favorite.
So I would love... So let's try to get a tag on that Timberwolf. All right, we got the tag on it. That's our primary target right now. This 30-tonner, what is this piece of junk? Arctic cheetah? What? They're sending Arctic cheetah against an assault lance? That's pretty crazy. They must be pretty desperate.
Yeah.
Right, we got a 55-tonner.
Actually, they might be so desperate that they're taking a model prisoners and letting him fight for them.
We got a Black Lantern.
A what?
Black Lantern. I mean, this is supposed to be a four-skull mission. I'm not really seeing anything that's too scary right now. And another 60-tonner. All right. Now, one thing they are doing is they're getting vision on us, which means that their turrets can start shooting at us, too. All right, this Timberwolf S. Oh, it's got large pulses on it. All right, here come the turrets. Knew that was going to come. All right. Okay. All right, let's push forward with our Warhawk. Horrible hit percentages here. Go ahead and take the shots on the Black Lantern. No luck.
Okay, so what are you gonna do?
Well, we're gonna keep taking shots at range because we kind of have an advantage because we have more mechs, so we'll just take long range shots. There we go, there's a good hit. More turret firepower. So it looks like the real danger in this mission so far is the turrets. So the best way of dealing with that is to take away the turret's vision. So we're going to try to take out these medium mechs as quickly as possible. Good shot on that Black Lantern. Yeah, even if your hit percentage is horrible, if you have enough shots, eventually you're going to do some damage. So, comes that Arctic Cheetah. What's it gonna do? Melee? Nope, just moving in a little closer. Alright, so this Timberwolf is letting itself get flanked. That's no bueno. Let's actually do a precision strike here. Pretty hard shot to the back there on that Timberwolf. Hit it again. Not the best hit percentages, but be nice if that Timberwolf pilot would eject.
Seem like it did much.
It stressed the pilot out.
You'd think they'd already be stressed.
Well, they are clan warriors. It's pretty hard to stress them out because they're not necessarily the sharpest tools in the shed.
They gotta be smart enough to know how to work those mechs.
Well, they're trained to use their mechs since they were born. I think even if we got our dog, if we put a dog in a mech, eventually it would learn how to use it.
Unless it's the mascot. Unless it's your mascot, he's not that bright.
That's true. Good hit. Another good hit on the Timberwolf. Again, if your hit percentages are lousy, but you only have one or two targets, it gets to the point where it just makes sense just to hit them hard at long range. Eventually, you'll get them. Here we go. We got knocked down on that Timberwolf. And a pilot injury. Alright, Timberwolf is back up. Let's see what he does. Is he going in for melee? No. He's repositioning and bracing. Okay. Oh, we've got a 60 tonner. Not too bad there. Right, Black Lantern. Black Lantern looks like it's coming in for melee on our Shadow Cat. Oh, it actually hit, which is unusual because Clan Mechs have a -4 quirk against melee, so whenever they hit, it's lucky. All right, we got a Warhawk. Uh-oh. All right, we lost some evasion on our Shadow Cat. That's why that Warhawk was able to shoot at long range. Really lucky shot. All right, they're going to keep going after our Shadow Cat. Ouch. All So we're actually going to move our Shadow Cat. It's got great opportunity to hit this Arctic Cheetah in the rear. We're going to do Precision Strike. Arctic Cheetahs don't have a lot of rear armor. And there goes the Arctic Cheetah. Alright. We can actually move up another Shadow Cat. Can get a rear shot at this Black Lantern. Again, Black Lanterns don't have a lot of rear armor either. All right, there goes the Black Lantern as well. Okay. It's a pretty good start to this turn. Pretty good hit percentages here. Timberwolf, especially if you do precision strike. Let's head shoot for the legs. All right, we took out a leg. And that'll give us another pilot injury. Yep. Have that Timberwolf pretty much under control. So let's start moving the main body back towards the prison. Well, they use the Warhawk to sensor lock, which is a little strange. Using a Warhawk as a sensor locker is pretty much a waste of one of the better mechs per tonnage out there. Warhawk is a great mech. Good firepower, great armor, pretty good speed for a mech of its size. And to use that as a sensor locker doesn't make too much sense. Although, we just lost a weapon, so maybe it does make sense. All right, let's keep moving the Annihilator. And as we get some good shots on the other leg of this Timberwolf. All right, we got another pilot injury. And he ejected. And we got two salvageable parts, so we should be able to put together another Timberwolf after this. Which would be nice, because I only have one Timberwolf right now. I'd like to have two. Has a good shot on that Warhawk at long range. Let's go ahead and take those shots. One hit out of three. Get a tag on this Warhawk. All loop this to active pro ping here. Is that an Alcorn? Yeah, that's an Alcorn, I think. They are nasty. Yep, Alcorns are much more dangerous than that Lupus. Warhawk. Moving up. Taking a shot at our Shadow Cat with high evasion. Didn't even get close. Let's hit this Warhawk at long range. Here comes that Alcorn. Gotta try to hit that Alcorn because that Alcorn has triple Gauss rifle. So maybe next turn we'll be able to hit that Alcorn. Meantime, we can take a shot at this Lupus Prime. Not really excited about salvage here, so we'll just do two precision strikes. Bit of structural damage there, but then again, we're not going to be. We're going to be traveling after this mission, so a little structural damage isn't that big of a deal. This falls in the category of having plenty of ammo, so we're just gonna take some shots at that Lupus, even if it was long range. Let's push up with our Stone Rhino. Alright, got good hit percentages on this Alcorn. We're gonna take this shot because that Alcorn has three Gauss rifles on it. All right, there goes the Alcorn. That was great. Before it could even get a shot off at us. Warhawk, hopefully, with this Gauss. Nice hits there. So my question is, can we get the... Alright, so we can actually get our Shadow Cat into the rear arc of this Warhawk. Let's take that shot for sure. Alright, I got knocked down. other. Sensor locker, highly evasive. And we'll get a sensor lock on this lupus. Got a Nova Cat. Not too worried about a Nova Cat. Good shot at this center torso of this Warhawk. Let's take their shots. Headshot, pilot injury. And he ejected. Great. So we got three parts of a Warhawk available as well. Remember, we can keep seven pieces of salvage here. We're going to have to use some of that salvage on our Shadow Cats, but that's okay. That's what they're there for. Right, let's push forward with our Warhawk here. Let's hit this silver bullet turret. Take out the turrets first if we can. Ooh. Rough shots on our Shadow Cat there, even with high evasion. Otherwise, it probably would have been destroyed. Precision strike on this lupus. All the Ultra AC-10s at the center torso. There goes the lupus. All right, so we got four more members of that support lance. We've got the Nova Cat, and then we have a couple more vehicles. Alright, we got a Puma and another heavy vehicle hanging out in that canyon over there. Alright, one problem at a time. Royal King Crab. Can hit that silver bullet turret. There we go, there goes the silver bullet turret. Storm Rhino can hit. Oh, silver bullet turret didn't get destroyed. Let's make sure we fix that right now. There we go. Shadow Cats have been beat up enough this mission, I think. So I think we're going to have them pull back at this point. I don't mind doing minor repairs to the Shadow Cats, but don't want them getting too much damage or having significant pilot injuries. might just be a turn of us pushing up. Nice. Alright, the Warhawk can actually get some vision. What do we got here? We got a Rhino support tank. And we got a Nova Cat. Let's do precision strike on the Nova Cat, center torso. That guy does not have a lot of armor. And I don't really care about salvage on the Nova Cat, so I'd like to just get rid of that guy as quickly as possible. Nothing's better at getting rid of something with center torso strikes more than the Annihilator. So we got three AC-10s available. Center torso strike. All right, there goes the Nova Cat. So we got three vehicles left and some turrets, and then we just destroy the base. It's going pretty well at this stage. Looks like they're going to get a cooldown round. Let's see if we can move up our Shadow Cats just enough that we can get some sensor locks. Heavy Shredder turret. Pushing forward. One of the negatives of these assaults is sometimes they're just so slow. Good hits on that Shredder turret though. Do some multi-target here. Hit the turret with the PPCs. And Rhino fire support tank with the, with the large pulse lasers. Alright, there goes the turret. Good damage on the Rhino. There goes that Rhino. Right, we got a Puma. forced it out of the ravine because no one else had vision on it, on us. Lots of firepower comes out of that Puma. They're very dangerous. Fortunately, this one does not have a lot of armor. All right, we got through most of the armor there on the Puma. See if our King Crab can finish it off. Goes the Puma. Oh, great. Enemy reinforcements. Where are the enemy reinforcements? Oh. I love it when the enemy reinforcements just show up in the, like, right next to your lance. I don't see how they could have gotten that close without being detected, but hey, video game. All right?
Yep.
Video game. Might not make sense, but that's the way it works. Let's find more reinforcements. There's more salvage. No problem. All right, we got a Mars assault vehicle. Let's try to get a tag on it. Those are pretty powerful, so we want to take that out as quick as we can. Get this heavy shredder turret. There goes the heavy shredder turret. Alright, let's focus on taking out this Mars assault vehicle.
Mars assault vehicle? Are you on Mars?
Nope. That's just the brand name. Now you can see why we're trying to take it out, because it's got a lot of firepower. Percentages on that Mars assault vehicle. Not enough to take it out. Alright, King Crab should be able to finish it off. There we go, there goes the Mars assault vehicle. So we've got a lance of reinforcements to deal with. one more turret, and we have to destroy the enemy base. Right, we're going to keep going after our Shadow Cats. Oh, Sun Spider. That's not good. This is what happens when the enemy just magically appears behind you. Alright, I don't want Gridlock to take any more injuries, so we're gonna go ahead and just eject.
Where goes that, Nick?
No, it'll just take a data repair. It doesn't really have anything in the head that's irreplaceable. Let's see if we can get a sensor lock. This 60 tonner. We got the reinforcements to deal with here, so we'll probably have our Warhawks kind of focus on taking out these enemy vehicles, and we'll push our assaults, our enemy reinforcements, and I'll push our assaults in to finish off the base. A pretty good strategy. A Warhawk should have no problem finishing these guys off. We'll let our assaults get in on the fun while they move towards the enemy base. Horrible hit percentages here, but it really doesn't matter. We're just kind of spamming the enemy here. It's a lot of AC-10 shots, even if half of them missed. Here as well. If they keep sending their reinforcements in one at a time, it's not going to go well for them. Shadow Cat take out some of those buildings while it waits. Rider. We got a Thunderbolt turret down there. All right, and that just forced all the enemy to show themselves. Finish off that Lupus. Oof, I thought that would have finished off that Lupus for sure. Be finishing up this mission pretty quickly here. Good hits on that Lupus. Just have to finish off these reinforcements and take out those buildings. There goes one enemy structure. Almost a second enemy structure. And our Royal King Crab's probably going to overheat there. Cat finish off this last enemy building. Alright, where's the LZ? It's almost always where you don't want to go. I could go to the LZ, but there's some decent salvage still on the field. Sun Spider's got a lot of firepower for 70 tons, but it's running hot. Here comes the other Sun Spider. Same thing, ton of missile firepower. Hopefully a Warhawk can hit weather the storm. Trying to knock down our Warhawk. Hang in there, Warhawk, hang in there. Last thing we want is for one of our mechs to get knocked down at this point of the game. Make this Hellbringer pay a little bit. Good hits there on that Warbringer. Or the Hellbringer. I'm gonna do the same thing again. These Hellbringers are easy to take off the field if you hit them enough in the center torso. Pretty quickly, there we go. Alright, let's bring up our Annihilator. Percentages here on this Sun Spider. Same thing. Let's hit this Sun Spider pretty hard. Dual Gosses. PPC. Going after that Warhawk again. Got some structural damage. Nothing too bad. You hit that Warhawk again. Thing is, our Warhawk hasn't lost any weapons. So let's take one of these guys off the field. Alright, there goes that Lupus. Hit our Sun Spider that already has some damage. Sun Spider that already has damage. Knock down. Finish off that Sun Spider, hopefully. Yep, there goes the Sun Spider. That's already left. Shadow Cat can keep working on this Thunderbolt turret. Keep going after our Warhawk. Warhawk still doesn't have any serious component damage. That's how tough they are. Still wants to stay in the fight here. Let's hit that Sun Spider. Center torso. gets there. Another Warhawk. And let's go ahead and hit that other Sun Spider center torso. There we go, there goes the Sun Spider. Interstellar Marauder is not going to stand up very long against all these clan mechs. Do some multi-targeting here. Help with that Thunderbolt turret. And hit the Marauder. Knock down. Rhino can finish off this turret. There we go. Alright, so if we can just take out this Marauder, that'll be the end of this mission. Going after our Warhawk. It's definitely going to need some repairs. That's kind of what Warhawks are for. Doing a little tanking. Lost a couple heat sinks, but it hasn't lost any weapons yet. Hot, so let's go center torso. Almost enough. This should finish off that Marauder. There we go. All right, that should be it for this mission. 17 rounds. Just take a quick look at our salvage choices, and then we'll close out this video. good payment, mostly because we had all those waves of enemies to take out. Warhawk is going to need a little bit of repairs. Same thing for the Shadow Cat and the other Shadow Cat. Let's look at our salvage option. I wish this would sort by tonnage. Let's see. So we got Warhawk F. We'll take that. We get two pieces of a Timberwolf. Looks like we should just take two parts of the Sun Spider C and see if we end up getting all the parts of the Sun Spider C. We did. So we're getting a Sun Spider out of this, we're getting a Warhawk out of this, and we're getting enough parts to put together a Timberwolf. So theoretically, we're getting three heavy mechs out of that mission. Not too bad. And that's going to do this for this video. We'll see you soon here on Commando Gaming and Battletech Battles.